Now we have in chapter 25, Amaziah was 25 years old when he began to reign. He reigned 29 years in Jerusalem. His mother's name was Jehoiadam of Jerusalem, and he did that which was right in the sight of the Lord, but not with a perfect heart. He was a pretty good king, you see. Now it came to pass, when the kingdom was established to him, that he slew his servants that had killed the king his father. He took vengeance upon them. But he slew not their children, but did as it is written in the law in the book of Moses, where the Lord commanded, saying, the fathers shall not die for the children, neither shall the children die for the fathers, but every man shall die for his own sin. That's a very important statement. You may have a very godly mother, but you'll never go to heaven because of a godly mother. You go to heaven because of the faith that you will exercise yourself in Christ. It has to be personal. And you'll never be judged because of the sins of your mother, your sins of your father. You stand judged on the basis of your own. This is a tremendous principle that's put out in here. Now we find that Amaziah gathered Judah together and made them captains over 1,000. He's getting ready for war, and he also hires an army. And there came a man of God to him. Now I'm dropping down to verse 7. O king, let not the army of Israel go with thee, for the Lord is not with Israel, to wit, with all the children of Ephraim. But if thou wilt go, do it. Be strong for the battle. God shall make thee fall before the enemy, for God hath power to help be cast down. Now he warns Amaziah, trust God. And he has the example that's been given to him by Jehoshaphat in the past, and Asa, and yet notice what happens. If thou wilt go, do it. Trust God, you see. And Amaziah said to the man of God, but what shall we do for the 100 talents which I've given to the army of Israel? The man of God answered, the Lord's able to give thee much more than this. Then Amaziah separated them, to wit the army that was come to him out of Ephraim, to go home again. Wherefore their anger was greatly kindled against Judah, and they returned home in great anger. And Amaziah strengthened himself, led forth his people, went to the valley of Salt, that would be down at the Dead Sea, and smote the children of Seir 10,000, and so on. I'm dropping down to verse 14. It came to pass after that Amaziah was come from the slaughter of the Edomites, that he brought the gods of the children of Seir, set them up to be his god. This is amazing that this man would do a thing like this. But it reveals the iniquity that's in the human heart. Verse 15, wherefore the anger of the Lord was kindled against Amaziah, and he sent unto him a prophet, which said to him, why hast thou sought after the gods of the people, which could not deliver their own people out of thine hand? Came to pass as he talked with him that the king said unto him, art thou made of the king's counsel? Forbear, why shouldst thou be smitten? Then the prophet forbear and said, I know that God hath determined to destroy thee, because thou hast done this and hast not hearkened unto my counsel.